Hello, love. Welcome home to Eden. This is Eve Christoph, your love life muse. Stick with me for the hottest news and subscribe to this channel to get somewhere new. We're on the 88 ways to pleasure the feminine. And right now, we're basically exploring the power chakra, sharing power. Okay, so this is one of the 88 ways to pleasure the feminine is to actually free her to be extraordinary, to support her to be extraordinary. Now the thing is, a lot of you men, you want the ordinary. You want non-complicated, you want your life to be simple and easy because if you're very masculine, you're linear. You just want things to go simple and easy. Now we know that the feminine is complex. She can handle the complexities of life, and she doesn't dumb anything down, and she doesn't make everything just like good or bad. You know, she knows there's not really such a thing because there's all of these different levels of reality going on. So here we go. You can be normal. You can have a normal life. Yes, you can. And you can have your strong focus and your simple routines. But she can be extraordinary. So let's look at this. So most of the men, they're thinking, if I want a normal life, then the woman's got to be normal too. But this is what they're actually saying. They're saying they want a woman to be their servant. Is she your servant? She does your laundry. She does your all kinds of tasks you don't want to have to do. Is she your shadow? Does she just sort of watch you go about life and just hang out there all the time? They want her to be their mirror. Like they're always mirroring what you say and just sort of like showing you back to you so you can talk nonstop about your problems and your little worries and she'll just mirror you. They want her to be silent, not troublesome, right? Not talk too much, not share too much. Does she agree with everything and make your life easy so you don't have to grow? See, this is what men think is the great woman, the normal woman. Is she complicit with your addictions? Like, does she drink with you? Oh, great, that's a great woman, haha. Does she enable your gambling habits and your toxic drinking and your negativity and join in with it? So that will make your life so easy, you think. Except for in the end, you'll feel empty, lonely, disgusted, and bored, and deeply despairing, like life is empty. So the extraordinary woman, okay, let's check this out. The extraordinary woman, she's got love at the center of her being, right? That means family's her heartbeat, and sexuality and closeness is her life's blood, you know? And she's got mission and life purpose. And she's free and she's able to move and she doesn't depend on you for her freedom, but she does need to be blessed in her freedom instead of receiving toxic jealousy over her powerful freeness, right? So, but the thing is, because family's at her center, that means she's going to be confronting, guiding, and protecting fiercely when things are going like crap. Like, she's going to want communication. She's not going to make it easy for you to just say nasty things and get away with it. Okay? That's the extraordinary woman. Now, because love is at the center, she won't put up with meanness and stonewalling and gaslighting her, making her think it's her fault. She won't put up with you lying, blaming, shaming her, or your victimhood, your bullying, none of it. And she's going to be willing for you to confront her on those things too, because she's going to want to grow. She's all about growth. So you're like, oh, this is what love is. This is what love is. Love is not the woman who's so nicey-nice, let you get completely trampled as a kid and did nothing. That wasn't the mama who was in her feminine. That would be the mama in her her own victim, her own powerlessness. But the wild feminine, the powerful feminine is powerful, full of power. And she can empower you and fill you with energy if you support her in her power. We're on the power chakra, okay? Now, because she needs sexuality as her spirituality, right? Then that means she needs a high vibration. Yeah, she needs you to be clean and clear and to get less and less addicted to pharmaceuticals and cigarettes and alcohol. And I mean, you don't have to be perfect. She's going to be a wild woman. She's going to want to, you know, do her magic mushroom, psilocybin, or bufo retreats like me, like in the wilderness. But she will not be wanting to live in a stupefied state of numbness. Her point of doing anything she does is to awaken more rather than to go to sleep to relax. She's going to want to give you massages to relax rather than anesthetize you, right? But because sexuality is so important to her, she's going to need you to dance with her. She's going to need you to do tantric rituals that engage the other chakras of your heart and your mind and your creativity. And she's going to need actual lovemaking. So that means like really daring to fall in love, to have your heart open, to have your heart be broken open. And she's going to be willing to have that also, to have her heart being open, but that doesn't mean she should be trampled or taken for granted because she's so open, right? So that's the other thing. The woman opens up wide and this guy's just like, I've got her. I don't have to, I'll put her on the shelf now. She's going to be about pussy pleasure, okay? That means feminine-centered lovemaking. And so she's going to want equality in the bedroom, but the thing is, equality for the woman means you need to give her more than you get. And then once you start learning that, that her body takes more, then you will get more than you've ever, ever gotten in your entire lifetime. You'll be completely inundated with pleasure, because that's what happens when she, that fountain explodes for her. She becomes a torrent of giving. Okay, but if you don't go there with her to the actual lovemaking of heart-connected chakra sharing, she'll be bored, and she'll notice that it's all by rote, and you're just banging, and you're not actually kissing. Kissing is so, so important. Okay, so power sharing here means you are empowering her. Think of her as Wonder Woman. Okay, did you ever see the Wonder Woman movie that came out with that extraordinary actress, what was her name? Gab Gadot? Oh, no, she's got some quite crazy name. The recent Wonder Woman, you know, she saves the planet because the men around her support her in her power. They believe in her. They follow her when she knows she's true. They deepen themselves when she confronts them. So if you've got Wonder Woman beside you, you need to be like okay with her greatness and understand that your greatness to her is different. She values your simplicity. She values your groundedness. She values your normalcy because it helps her to have that power. And it's awesome to her that you have this linear focus that can be so grounded and simple and powerfully connected to the moment. She loves that. So the first thing to do is to work on your jealousy tendency that will totally destroy love with the woman when you're constantly focusing on her. She's so beautiful. Other guys are going to want her. And then what the guy's going to want to do when he's in jealousy is he goes into this thing where, oh, I'm going to make her feel insecure. I'm going to withdraw my love to keep her from shining so much. And that will make me safer, because then she won't have so many guys after her, because she'll be all obsessed over me, feeling insecure and sad and brokenhearted. And it's unconscious. But the guys will actually do this thing of undermining Wonder Woman to make themselves feel strong and equal like Superman. But hey, you know what? Your superpower as men, it's not always the same as the feminine. I mean, some men are very feminine and they have the feminine superpowers. But usually her superpowers are extraterrestrial. They're spiritual. They're inner. They're mystical. And that's how she operates. And yours are often grounded, physical, present time, logical. And as long as you don't stop her powerful torrent of energy with your limited logic, like saying, she says, listen, I feel it. We got to get out of here. There's danger coming. And you go, that makes no sense. I don't want to have to listen to you. You don't know anything about this location. Now you have cut off her connection to the divine superpower. Whereas if you're the kind of man who goes, really? You're having that feeling again? Oh my God, okay, let's just go. let's just be unattached to this moment. Let's, you know, it may or may not be the perfect thing that you understand how where you end up when you leave that party. But if you do this over time, following the intuition of the feminine, the magical guidance of her dreams, you will find your life empowering in unbelievable ways that you have never, ever dreamt of before. Because she will dream for you. She will dream for you, the family, and the community. And all she needs is for you to understand that Wonder Woman needs a hero, a champion by her side, who is in his masculine groundedness of supporting her. Okay? Power sharing. Free her to be extraordinary. Support her in extraordinary. And do not tell her, I've never had these problems with any other woman. You should just not speak up so much. None of the other women ever complained like you do. So, because you don't want to learn, right? You don't want to grow with what she's confronting. Don't do that. Don't ask her to be normal. The normal woman of ancient times is tamped down, is depressed, is destroyed, is weakened, is lonely, is disconnected, is masculine, actually. Don't ask her to be normal. Don't want her to be normal. Listen, there's no such thing. And you have been sold a bill of lies in terms of what the happiness on this planet can offer you, in terms of what this world is about. It's not about your entitled getting all the goodies that you want to get all the time. It's about growth. This planet is about constant growth and getting and chopping the growth so it stops, it doesn't turn into cancer. And then this planet, it's about polarities in opposition and constantly surrendering into the newness. You know, the newness of exchange of energy. You don't get to just take like capitalism suggests. So if you can't just take, that means with the feminine, especially the feminine, it's an exchange. And the funny thing is, if you exchange with her support of her power, I mean, that's not even having to give her much. All it is like saying yes to her power, and then she showers you. So what's the big deal? Why is that so exhausting? It's because your ego feels insecure and unequal to her. But don't feel that way. Believe in yourself, believe in your lovability, believe that you are an awesome, handsome, hot, gorgeous, deep, meaningful, soulful, caring, loving provider of energetic exchange. Believe in yourself, okay? And what will happen is, you get to relax. You get to relax because the feminine, when you support her and free her into her extraordinariness, her Wonder Woman powers, oh gosh, she really is a fountain, and you get fed so much. Life is so much more interesting. It may not always seem like it's easier, but actually it is much easier over time. The grace of being in the spiritual flow, it starts adding up into a life of extraordinary abundance. At first, it may look hard because you're being confronted on your addictions and your childishness and or your sleepy boredom, your way of not being awake. At first, you'll be like, this is too much work. But as soon as you get used to being awake, oh, you're gonna be like, I don't want to go back to sleep. If I go to sleep, I want to dream. I want to be in the story. I want to be co-creating. And when you realize that you're a co-creator with her, like you start supporting her and then she goes, well, what do you want? What do you dream? And you realize, oh, she means it. She means it that if we dream together, it's going to come true. And you start actively participating in the dream. You're not going to want to be drinking so much. You're not going to want to be, just zoning out, staring into space. You know, you're actually going to want to love yourself enough to listen to your own dreams. And then the challenge will be not to be in that linear masculine state that goes, oh, as soon as I start feeling my dreams, I have to leave her so I can focus on my dreams because she's in my way. No, you're supporting each other's dreams, right? And that will make you exponentially more powerful. I mean, the Huichol Indians know this. They are a great, deep tradition of the mystical goddess. And they know that when a couple is married and deeply providing for each other, devoted to each other, and they don't cheat on each other, they become a container for sacred energy that gets exponentially more and more powerful. And spirit can pour into the couple and pour through them, the stronger their devotion is to each other. Okay, so dream on that, baby. Put that, smoke that, and put that in your pipe. A little buffo toad prayerful wish for you. I love this toad of the forests. I'm so fascinated by the buffo toad. You should look it up. Okay, much love, darling.